Hello, clients and friends. This is Billy Doty from Doty Financial Group, and it's my pleasure to present our mid-year economic and market update. Today's agenda is very straightforward. First, we will share with you a brief economic and market update. Then we will discuss some proactive guidance moving forward. Before we begin, it's always important to review that there are five key areas of financial planning. These areas are preservation planning, retirement planning, tax planning, estate planning, and investment planning. As a comprehensive financial services firm, we try to always consider the impact of any recommendation we make on not just one, but all these areas for our clients. Today's presentation will be primarily focused on investment planning and equity markets. At our firm, we partner with clients and believe an educated client is our best client. While we will always try our best to help you when it comes to your finances, we believe that knowledge is power. One of our missions is to share with clients any knowledge that can help them make an informed decision. The first half of 2021 was a busy one. The United States inaugurated a new president and administration, vaccine distributions expanded, and COVID case reductions allowed for the reopening of many countries. Volatility continued in the equity markets, but investors still experienced record highs. And at the end of the second quarter, the Fed announced that potential changes to interest rates might come sooner than expected due to fast-paced inflation. 2021 opened the year with the backdrop of COVID and a new administration in the White House. Investors were happy to see that reopening started in the first half of 2021. Although, as this chart shows, there was volatility and some bumps, certainly not a straight line. At the midway point of 2021, investors saw the stock market post its second best first half in 23 years, with the S&P 500 hitting new highs. However, with new highs came some new concerns, and two of the most talked about issues at the end of the second quarter were inflation and interest rates. In economics, inflation is defined as a general rise in the price level of an economy over a period of time. When the general price level rises, each unit of currency buys fewer goods and services. Consequently, inflation reflects a reduction in the purchasing power per unit of money. Monetarists believe the most significant factor influencing inflation or deflation is how fast the money supply grows or shrinks. Therefore, during inflationary times, the Fed considers raising rates to slow down the money supply. The inflation expectation for 2021 was raised to 3.4%. Back in March, the Fed had anticipated a 2.4% inflation rate. In 2021, the U.S., as shown in this chart, has seen its highest levels of inflation since 2008. Inflation is a real concern for savers because it eats into purchasing power and lifestyle. It is always a good idea for investors to try to at least keep pace or exceed inflation rates. However, looking at history, we're nowhere near the highest nor the lowest periods of inflation in the past 90 years. We're keeping an eye on inflation and interest rates and any changes that may affect our clients. Inflation, as we stated earlier, is a decrease in the purchasing power of money, reflected in a general increase in the price of goods and services in an economy. Today, the price for many consumer goods are significantly higher than they were 50 years ago. When you hear someone's grandparents say, "When I was your age, a cup of coffee was 25 cents," they're making a statement about inflation. Simply put, investors need to watch the rising cost of goods and services over time and the decrease in the purchasing power of their money. Economically speaking, inflation affects interest rate levels. The higher the inflation rate, the more interest rates are likely to rise. This occurs because lenders will demand higher interest rates as compensation for the decrease in purchasing power of the money they are paid in the future. In general, when interest rates are low, the economy grows and inflation increases. Conversely, when interest rates are high, the economy slows and inflation decreases. At the Federal Reserve's June meeting, they concluded by sharing that the Federal Reserve considerably raised its expectations for inflation this year and brought forward the time frame on when it will next raise interest rates. Fed officials indicated that rate hikes could come as soon as 2023, after saying in March that it saw no increase until at least 2024. The so-called dot plot of individual member expectations pointed to two rate hikes in 2023. However, the central bank gave no indication as to when it will begin cutting back on its aggressive bond buying program, though Fed Chairman Jerome Powell acknowledged that officials discussed the issue at the meeting. As expected, the Policymaking Federal Open Market Committee still unanimously left its benchmark short-term borrowing rate anchored near zero. What is the dot plot? The dot plot maps policymakers' predictions on interest rates. As a result of studying the 2008 crisis, the dot plot was created as a tool to offer guidance on possible future interest rate moves. Four times a year, the Federal Open Market Committee, or the FOMC, publishes a Summary of Economic Projections, SEP. This includes multiple-year forecasts of key economic indicators, such as gross domestic product, GDP, inflation, and unemployment. It also includes each member's predictions for interest rates within the three following years and beyond. Has the dot plot been accurate? The dot plot is essentially an outlook or prediction. The dot plot is a relatively new tool for the FOMC, with its commencement in 2011. Since then, it has had a rather shaky track record. Fed Chair Jerome Powell believes that the dots are not a great factor for future rate moves, and it's just because it's so highly uncertain. Ultimately, the central bank will base its policy on outcomes, not predictions. After the Fed announced its change in projections, Treasury yields experienced some volatility. At the quarter's close, the 10-year Treasury yield was 1.456%, and the 30-year Treasury yield was 2.08%. Interest rates are critical when creating a diversified and balanced portfolio. Therefore, investors need to pay attention to interest rate movements. On July 8th, headlines read that the 10-year Treasury yield falls on global economic growth worries. Let's quickly look at how the Treasury market is showing volatility by focusing on the 10-year Treasury. CNBC reported that investors rotated into the perceived safety of bonds, pushing the 10-year Treasury yield below 1.26%, to the lowest since late February. Remember, bond yields move inversely to prices. They shared that despite the strengthening economy and hotter inflation, the 10-year yield continued to decline. As a point of reference, the 10-year Treasury had started July around 1.58%. It reached a 14-month high of 1.78% in March. It began 2021 at less than 1%. Even with this level of volatility, interest rates today are still at or near all-time lows, and these ultra-low rates might not help many investors reach their goals. Safety comes with a cost. Have you seen what interest rates banks are currently offering to savers? According to Barron's, the average bank money market rates on July 6, 2021 were 0.07%. And the average 12-month CD rate was 0.17%. At a rate of 0.17% without taxes, it would take over 350 years to double your money. Again, for many investors, today's ultra-low rates might not help them reach their goals. Therefore, equities could be a part of your diversified portfolio. Investors will always face many tempting distractions. Media magnification is a powerful source. Sensational headlines can leave investors overwhelmed, stressed, and confused. Our objective is to help you carefully create and follow a strategy with realistic financial goals. veering off course in the hopes of short-term gains could potentially compromise the financial fortitude of your long-term goals. Call us if you have any questions about your path, and please contact us before making any sudden moves. Also, your personal health is imperative, and stress doesn't help. So let's all try to stay healthy. Equity market volatility is still present. Equity markets can always see downturns or declines, which are a normal part of the investment experience. Now is an excellent time to move forward with confidence in the path you've chosen towards your investment goals. But remember, equity markets are currently high, and we will always like to alert clients that we need to proceed with caution. As a quick recap, here are some key points. Despite continued volatility, all three major indexes finished the first half with strong positive results. Continued vaccine distributions and reopenings are driving the economy forward. Interest rates remain at near zero, but are projected to increase in 2023. Inflation is moving forward quicker than expected. Also, caution is still the principal notion for investors. Please avoid distractions that sway you from the path to your goals. Focus and make sure your time horizon and risk appetite are congruent with your goals. And as always, call us with any concerns. Jeff Bezos, currently the world's richest person, stepped down as CEO of Amazon on July 5. While Bezos will still be Amazon's largest shareholder, he will now focus his energies on new products and initiatives. In 27 years as founder and CEO, he built a garage-based company into one of the most successful businesses in history. He believed in a day-one philosophy and stated he was still treating the company as if it was a startup, even after it was first publicly listed. He transformed the company from selling books online to a place where shoppers can now find millions of products on an internet-based mega mall. Now, as he leaves his post as day-to-day overseer of this great success story, in his last letter to investors, instead of taking a victory lap, he cited new challenges, showing that he maintains the company still has goals and is continuing a day-one philosophy. The dot-com bubble in 2000 extinguished many dot-com companies. Although Amazon stock survived, it lost more than 90% of its value. Throughout this tough time period, Bezos remained grounded on his foundational principles and long-term success goals. While many of his peers folded, he made sure Amazon continued to evolve and grow. Early Amazon investors who kept their eye on long-term goals and stayed the course through even the most difficult times have been rewarded with impressive gains. So what can you expect from us? One of our main focuses is to review changes for our clients on an ongoing basis. You can expect regular communication, more frequent discussions, and you can expect that we are continuously reviewing economic, tax, estate, and investment issues for our clients. In fact, we will be offering other workshops that highlight tax changes and planning ideas. We appreciate our clients. As a client benefit, you can add names to our distribution list for viewing this workshop. We hope you'll take advantage of this and add two names or more to our list. One of our goals for 2021 is to continue to help others. Some of our best clients were referred to us by existing clients, so please feel comfortable letting us know the name of anyone who you feel could benefit from our services or information. Again, one of our primary goals is to keep clients informed, and we appreciate you watching our update. Please call us if you have any questions. We're thankful for the opportunity to assist you with your financial needs. Remember, at our firm, clients come first, and your health and well-being is our highest priority.